Ladies and gentlemen, your host, Sam Shane Brown.
Hi, my name is Sam Shane Brown, and I'm actually starting to dig the new entrance. You know what? I thought it was going to be a little weird at first. I've been entering from over there for quite some time now, but you know what? I think the new entrance is really starting to grow on me. We have a fun little show planned for you all today. We actually decided to do something productive for a change this week. We're going to interview and play some games with two very, very important people here at LHS. But before that, we're gonna do some shenanigans. We're gonna do some classic Sam shenanigans. We haven't done a Sam versus people in quite some time, so here is part three, I believe, of Sam versus people. Let's take it away. See you shortly. Hi, my name is Sam Shane Brown, and we haven't done one of these in a while, so here we are with a Sam versus people part three, because I hate people and my name's Sam.
All right, I'm here with
Ethan.
Ethan, how are you doing today?
Good.
Are you a freshman?
Yeah.
How have you been enjoying high school so far?
I hate it.
All right, I am here with my good friend and former band member, Mr. Alex Weiss. How are you doing?
I'm chilling.
So, the nails is right. All right, how are you doing?
I'm very good. How are you?
I'm doing very well. What's your name?
Abi.
Abi. What would you describe this sweater that you're wearing as?
It's from Costco.
Do you remember me? I was your lab partner last year. Are these your french fries?
Well, I took them from someone, but yeah.
Who'd you take them from?
Leo.
You took them from this kid over here?
Yeah, short kid.
The short kid? The one that's over there?
Yeah.
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. Your friend Ethan over there, I just want to let you know that he took your french fries.
Holy sh**, I'm famous!
What color would you say that is?
Maroon.
Maroon? It's like a maroonish brown.
Yes, I would say that, yes.
Yeah. You guys might not know this, but that right there is the our director here at Office Hours. And right next to him is Jackson Weiss. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty well, Sam. How are you?
I'm doing fine, thank you. What's your relationship with Miles Dax like?
It was shaky for a bit, but I'd say we're back to being best buds again.
Why was it shaky for a bit?
He said something else.
Whoa, look who I'm here with. I'm here with Dylan.
Hey, guys.
You might recognize him because he's on the episode you're watching right now. That is, unless you're skipping to the good part, which is this part, because Sam's the best. What's your name?
Eli.
Eli, are you aware that you have an entire plastic container filled to the brim with blueberries?
Yeah, I'm aware.
Yeah, you're like the king of fashion around town, right?
Basically,
at this point, with your maroonish brown line of sweaters.
Yep.
I like the buttons too. The buttons.
Oh yeah, thank you.
The buttons are really what makes it. Can you open that container for me? All right. Here's the game. Each one of you gets a single blueberry. Whoever consumes the blueberry the fastest gets a crisp high five. You ready to go? This kid's confident. He's confident. I want some pre-game thoughts from
Michael.
Michael, what do you think? Before you embark on this intense battle, what is your strategies going into this blueberry eating competition?
I'm just going to swallow the whole thing. I'm not even going to chew it.
Swallow the whole thing. Don't even chew it. Heard it here first, kids. Are our seatbelts on?
Yes.
Ready? 3, 2, 1, go.
I think the kid in the back.
The kid in the back wins? Congratulations, my friend. What's your name?
Andrew Downey.
Andrew Downey, nice to meet you. You are now the blueberry eating champion of the world.
Thank you.
How do you feel?
Good.
Is there anybody at home that you'd like to thank?
My grandma. My grandma. And yeah, that's it.
Well, congratulations, grandma.
I'm famous! Whoa!
What do you think makes a good relationship?
When I touch his ears.
When It is time to give the people what they want. Raffi Steinberg is currently up there in his natural habitat. We're going to go pay him a visit. Raffi, how are you doing today?
Great.
Great. What makes today such a glorious day as you sit here in your beautiful MIT sweatshirt?
First, I'd like to thank Mustard for bringing me here. And
Mustard is stupid.
You're stupid, but on the topic of stupid, 84 on the bio test yesterday.
Genius. That's what I'm talking about. What about you, Leo? How are you doing in bio?
I'm doing good. I have an 83.
83, very impressive. What about you?
I got a 54 on my bio test yesterday.
Oh. Well then, how about this? Why don't you and Raffi get together after school for some study sessions?
I'll pass.
I'm coming for those French fries. Thank you. Mine. Run. Okay, a quick tour of the edit room. Here's mine. It says, caution, woman cave. The W-O didn't exist until recently. Somebody else brought that in. And we have my dartboard.
Scott Norwood is like the worst kicker of all time. Josh Allen is horrific. Daniel Jones is so much better than him. He's the worst quarterback. The Bills are not even gonna make the playoffs. And if they get to the Super Bowl, they're gonna lose to the Giants. To a field goal. To a freaking field goal.
Well, we'll see about that. Enjoy Saquon, my friend. Bye. And here's my my personal favorite edit booth, the Jordan Cooper Shrine booth. Look at these beautiful, beautiful images. Wow. Look at that hardworking, studious man right there. Look at that beautiful face. Wow. Look at him. I'm sending it back to the studio. Future Sam, take it away.
Thank you. I'm not sure why I decided to use that voice at the end of the Sam vs. People, but there you have it. Sam vs. People Part 3. I had a lot of fun doing that one. Congrats once again to the Blueberry Kid. What a talent. What a magnificent talent. All right, so I think it is just about time for us to introduce your two very special guests for the day. One of them was actually featured on the first ever episode of Office Hours, and he is back again. Please welcome Mr. Dylan Tovitz and Sia Bansal. Welcome, welcome, welcome. You are live from Studio A at LHS with the Office Hours crew, so we have two different forms of media colliding today. Isn't that right? How are you guys both doing today?
We are good. I am good. I am a little wet, actually. No, okay.
I'm a little wet?
Because Ben and I, before this, decided to walk to 7-Eleven in the rain. Mm. We underestimated the power of the rain, which was Ben's fault. So if my hair looks a little wet, that is why I was rained on. But besides that, I'm good.
And how are you?
Good. Stressed, but good.
Yeah, I know. It's the highest stage we're performing on. Just so you know, we have an incoming call. Please wait. I don't know. Maryland wanted to speak to me. Alex, do you want to take my phone?
I'm taking it from her.
Okay, I was going to decline Maryland. My apologies.
You don't deserve this.
My apologies.
You'll get it back when you're done with the show.
I'm having my phone taken away from me. All right. Well, so I have a few questions for both of you. I have written a few articles for The Lance in the past, but I want this to be for the people out there that aren't really sure how to submit an article or what their articles should be about. So first of all, what is The Lance and what's the goal that The Lance is trying to accomplish?
So The Lance is Livingston High School student-run newspaper. It's entirely student-led. All of the editors are current students. I'm the editor-in-chief. I'm a senior this year. And we have Mr. Callahan as our advisor. So all the photo stuff from like the editing to the layout, it's all student-led.
Yeah. I mean, it's just an opportunity. Like Sam said, there are a lot of different forms of media. This, the TV studio and what we do here at Office Hours, that's kind of the broadcast journalism, broadcast media kind of aspect. And The Lance is more of the writing aspect. So And it's like a process, so it's for people kind of coming into high school that are interested in journalism. Like what I did is, in my sophomore year, I started by taking journalism, and so did Sia. Sophomore year or freshman?
I never took journalism.
Never mind, she never
really?
Took journalism.
No.
But you've been in...
I've been in the land since freshman year, yeah.
Right.
I was writing for it.
Right, yeah. So I took journalism in sophomore year, and then this is my first year in the newspaper class, which is, like, I'm an editor now. And next year I'm hoping to take it again, and maybe I'll take Sia's role, who knows. But yes, it's really just an opportunity for any students to contribute, to write, to put forth their opinions, or just really practice like journalism and write about news or sports or entertainment. There's a really wide range of kind of things you can write about, and it's really cool to get involved in.
That's interesting. So I think that taking the journalism class is like a way to get interested in writing for the Lance. What got you so interested in writing for the Lance without even taking that class in the first place?
I always liked writing. I did like the Heritage Middle School newspaper, so I wanted to join the Lance at the high school. And then sophomore year, I emailed the teacher and I was like, hi, I really want to get more involved. Is there any way I could do so? And he was like, sure. So I became an editor my junior year. But I guess the reason I like writing is because I like politics and entertainment and stuff, so it's a way for me to share my opinion. And then I really fell in love with the editing process, and Mr. Callahan chose me as an editor-in-chief, so that's like my little Lance journey.
Yeah, I have a similar, I'm kind of a year behind, but me too, I've always just kind of been interested in writing, and like more, like I know Sam, like you're in the past have been interested in like creative writing.
Yeah.
I'm less creative, just like as a person. Like I shouldn't say that.
Don't knock yourself.
I prefer the more formal writing process as opposed to creative writing. So kind of newspaper and reporting on news, it really kind of appealed to me. So that was kind of why I kind of started to go down that path, and I've enjoyed myself so far. So yeah.
So is there multiple different categories for people to write about, like different writing styles that come in together to make the newspaper?
So, for the most part, it's all like journalism and the style of writing, but there are different categories, I guess. Like, there's entertainment, hard news, school news, sports, which I know nothing about. What else? We have freelance, so people can do poetry and creative writing. That's where you could do like a different kind of writing. I think it's
features.
Features, there's also opinions and features. Yeah.
Opinions and features, yeah, that's more like kind of general anything, but yeah, I mean, opinion features are more general, I think. Opinions are interesting. Most students really like to write opinions because they have opinions, but it's also important to have kind of that traditional aspect of just reporting on news. So to answer your question, there's a wide variety of things you can write about, and like Sia said, like, or me personally, like, I don't know much about, like, entertainment, and Sia doesn't know much about sports, but like that's okay because we have multiple editors. Like it's not just
right.
us two. So like there's really a role for everyone. There's something to write about for everyone, and if you're interested in becoming an editor, there's something for everyone to do. You don't have to be like good at everything or knowledgeable about everything.
So you spoke about this a little bit, but that's got to be hard. Where exactly do you draw the line between opinions and keeping like an unbiased journalism voice, so to say?
Yeah, we're kind of struggling with that right now at the moment. It's funny you ask, because people generally are inclined to write their opinion because everybody has an opinion.
They're more passionate about their opinion
right.
than
and
just a topic.
Especially for the people that are writing, there's no like requirement, so you don't have to take like the journalism class. Last year in journalism, one of the like very key things we learned about was like how to report on news objectively and how important that is in like ethical journalism. And if you read like the New York Times or any of those traditional newspapers, the news is written objectively because it's not geared towards specific audiences, and it has to come from an objective viewpoint in order to be kind of fair and reliable.
Mm-hmm.
So in a student-run newspaper, it's a little tricky, but people eventually realize that there are sections, so you sign up for a section. So
right.
if you want to write about a news topic, and you want to have your opinion
month,
on it.
Each month, can you sign up for a different topic?
Correct. Each month, you can sign up for a different section, a different article, a completely different topic, and you can write as much as you want, like, reasonably as much as you want. Like, don't write, like, six articles. You can write six articles over the year, but you know what I mean. Yeah, I don't really know where I was going there. I kind of lost my train of thought.
That's good. We got some good information out of you, Dylan. Okay. All right, I have a few more questions, and then I think we're gonna play some games. All right, Ooh. So it's not all just gonna be boring back and forth. But here's one interesting question that I had is there like a limit to what I can write about? Can I write about anything per se, or are there certain things that can and cannot be published?
Yeah, this is a really good question because people want to write about things that sometimes can't be published, so you cannot write about anything, unfortunately. It's a school newspaper, so First Amendment does not apply, so you can't really criticize the school, or like it has to be very researched and very like thorough if you're writing a school news article that's like on something that's remotely criticizing like the administration. So there are limits to that, and there are also limits on hard news topics. It can't be too polarizing of a topic. Like, we try to stay away from, like, abortion and gun rights and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And then, is there anything else?
I was just going to say, like, the school is they're very, they will work with you if you have a topic and you want to get it published and it's, like, kind of crossing a little on that edge.
You'll find a way to make it more
suitable. Right,
so,
like, for example, I wrote an article for the first issue this year about, like, bringing more school spirit to Livingston, basically, and it was a little like it was a little on that border. So I sat down with Ms. Rosenzweig and we had a good conversation. We were able to get that published. So if you have a topic and you want to write about it and you're not sure whether it's like appropriate or not, we will work with you as like the Lance, and also the administration will work with you. It's pretty cool.
All right, and one more question. I know we have a few local businesses that watch us every week. Do you want to explain the new, because the advertisements are a new thing. Do you want to explain that for everybody watching?
Coming new this issue.
Okay, so Joel Peels, he is our ad coordinator this year. He had this really great idea to get local businesses send in like either job listings or just ads, coupons, like whatever for students in the lands, teachers, families of students. And the Lance editing team like went around town over break, and we were able to successfully get a few places to reach out or like agree to give us money for their ads. So in the December issue, there's going to be a bunch of ads, job listings for students, and also if you're a new business and you'd like to advertise, we're looking for ads.
Right. Yeah, that's just a great way we kind of found to like expand a little, because obviously like. It's a huge like audience to have this audience of 2,000 plus students. So to be able to kind of expand that to businesses around town and give them an option to advertise their product or try to find students to work, that was really a great idea by Joel, and we're excited to implement it.
All right, so you guys ready to play a game?
We are ready to play a game.
I think this leads nicely into a little game that we have prepared. So here's what's gonna happen. On the camera screen, we're gonna put up like a news headline, okay? These news headlines I have not seen. The only person that's seen this is the other producer. And so we're gonna put up these news headlines. We have six, and you have to guess if you think the news headline is a real news headline or if it's something that we made up. All right?
Sounds good.
Do we wanna make it a competition?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right,
ready? So here we go. All right, Dylan, you go first.
Oh boy.
I don't know if you can read it.
Low fuel light leads North Carolina woman to $1 million lottery prize. Oh boy.
Real or fake, Mr. Tovitz?
You know, it doesn't look like an article, but.
No, the formatting is different.
Formatting is different for all of them.
Yes, for all of them. So it's just focus on the headline.
Can you put it back up? Low fuel. Okay, I am going to say fake because. Okay, I'm gonna be overthinking this, but typically, if I'm making a fake news headline, why would I? More likely than not, the real lottery is not gonna be exactly $1 million. It might be like 1.4 or 1.6 or 7.3. But if I was making a fake news headline, I would make it like a round number like 1. Mm-hmm. So I'm saying fake.
Yeah, you're wrong.
That is a real
it was a good
news headline. See, Dylan, sometimes that big, beautiful brain of yours just doesn't stop working.
You see, yeah, I overthought it, but...
You tend to do that.
I feel like my thinking was...
Okay, all right, Sia, do you want to turn?
Yeah, but I'm kind of blind, so...
it's kind of hard to see. Let's, do we want... I think maybe we'll put it full screen. I think that might make it a little easier,
yeah,
but, all right, let's see it. Here's the next news headline.
I'll read it out loud.
Okay. Like at zero.
I can't see it either.
13,000 separate fire ant hills found in what's an ant?
An ant hill, where ants live.
Now it's gone.
And it's disappeared. Can we put it back up, please? Hello?
Okay.
We have nothing. Okay, so you know what we're gonna do? If this segment isn't working really well, we can't really, it's kind of difficult to see. I know, they can't see at home, but these cameras, they have like reflective stuff on it. It's kind of difficult.
I feel like we can kind of see it better now. Ben moved his camera forward, except it's
there. Do you want to try it again?
Okay,
there it is, now it's full screen. All right, let's see.
No.
Okay, 13,000 separate fire ant hills found in local Utah residents' backyard. Ooh. Okay, this is not my guess.
13,000. That's a lot of ant hills.
That is.
Yeah, are ant hills, is that like 13,000 ants?
Yeah,
on the hill?
I need to
know. No, it's 13,000
like,
separate
ant hills.
What is an ant?
13, oh, no, it's ants.
No, 13,000 separate ant hills. 13,000.
How
yeah.
big is this backyard?
The ant hills are small.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to go with fake news.
You are correct. That is fake news. That is not a real thing. I don't think 13,000 ant hills can fit in
I would have said real. That's too obscure to be. Okay, never mind. Keep
See,
going.
All right,
redeeming myself.
Dylan,
here.
Your turn again. Let's put up the next news headline.
Wisconsin resident arrested after refusing to leave a restaurant in protest of them not serving Cheerios on the menu. That is real.
No.
That
is not a real thing, Dylan. Boo. And the audience is booing you. That is back-to-back incorrect answers
for
Mr.
That's just sad. I'm usually the booer, not the booee.
Yeah, usually that's Dylan's job. He controls the booze.
Okay, but like again, like okay, that you know what? That's props to Miles for finding like fake headlines like that. Because like
I know.
That's like
you
that's something that would happen. What was this state? Ohio.
Cheerios. Yeah, Ohio. Anything
that's such
happens
an Ohio
in Ohio.
Thing. Like,
all right, go blue. Okay, let's put up one more news headline. See, it's your turn. Let's see if you could go right. 2 for 2.
One
let's
more.
Let's see the final headline.
Please read that.
Man's 174 mile per hour sneeze blows wife's hair off.
Wow. 174 miles per hour. Out of the nose.
Real.
If that's real, I quit.
That is a real
so
news headline.
Are you kidding
wow.
me?
Wow.
Blows her wife's
Was it
hair off.
Apparently
sure?
that happened.
Are we sure?
I don't know.
Trust this. That seems like yellow journalism.
We might have to fact check that.
Should I explain yellow journalism?
No, you shouldn't.
Okay,
the editors are saying that one is incorrect. We will see. We'll
Wait, am I the editor? Or the editors?
You are both the editors.
No, she said she guessed it was right.
Of the lamps.
Well, she guessed it was right. So maybe it's
just
me.
Oh, okay. Well, Dylan's just wrong. Dylan's
yeah.
just wrong. Okay.
Hey,
all right. Well, that was a fun game. So I think we move on to our final segment. I believe this is also a new addition to
yeah.
the Lance this year, which is the advice column.
Yeah.
So
do you want us to explain it?
Yeah, go ahead. Explain
okay.
it.
Okay. Here, you can explain it.
Is it Answers for
the Yeah, Answers
okay.
for the Lancers.
So Answers for the Lancers is the Lance editorial staff's advice column. So there's a Google form, I think, on our club Instagram
yeah.
And you can ask pretty much any sort of question for the most part as long as it's like school appropriate enough.
Yeah. No promise it'll get published.
Yeah,
no
and promises. We will do our best to give you very real, very serious advice only
mm-hmm.
For
very
these very
real,
important
very
questions
serious.
That people have been asking, so.
Okay, so.
All right, so you guys brought some for me to answer.
Yeah.
Yes, we
right?
did.
All right, so here is your very real and very serious
yeah.
advice answers. Sam says, on the Livingston Lance newspaper. Let me hear some questions.
Okay, yes, Please. And these are real, Sam just said this, but these are real questions we got from students.
Okay.
So this is, what do you guys recommend as the best Livingston restaurant?
The best Livingston restaurant. See, I wouldn't exactly describe Livingston as the food capital of the world. We have a few nice restaurants. First of all, I cannot do this segment without mentioning Toronto's, which is the best pizza place in town. Fantastic. Go check out season 2, episode 3. Toronto's is up there. Tony Boy's is up there. Do we want like a sit? Are they asking for a sit down meal or just
they
a bite?
They didn't specify,
eat?
But let's.
Let's assume sit down meal.
Let's say sit down meal sit to down like meal? Shrink your options a little bit.
Definitely not Nero's. Definitely not Nero's. What's Mezza? Mezza's in Livingston, right?
I've never heard of Mezza.
Yeah, I've never
Mezza's
heard of
in Livingston. It's by that coffee place near Shake Shack.
What is it?
It's Greek food. Enlighten Check us. Out Mezza. I ate there last weekend for the first time. It was pretty good. I had a nice steak sandwich. All right, next.
All right. As a sophomore, what elective should I take next year? I have a feeling I know what your first
Obviously,
thing
I'm
going to
say
be.
The best part The best thing about being a junior so far has been being in AM Wired. But it really depends on what you think you want to do and what classes you've enjoyed in the past. If you've taken TV classes, I would obviously recommend trying out for AM Wired. It's fantastic. We have a lot of fun. There's something for everyone. Do AM Wired. All right.
And also do the Lance.
Yeah,
and also
do the
Lance.
Lance.
And the Lance as well. All right. Give me one more.
All right.
Okay, really hard one. What came first, the chicken or the egg?
Well, this isn't exactly advice. This is more.
No, some of them are not advice. They're but this was an.
I see. Okay. The chicken or the egg? See, I'd say the egg, but then I'd say.
How did the egg get there?
But then then you say the chicken, but then how'd the chicken get there?
Pick
so
one.
You see this predicament. I'm gonna go with the egg came first. Due to evolution, other species made an egg that became the first ever chicken. But then you ask, where did those other species come from? Did the other species come from themselves or the egg? And it's a loop. I'm gonna go.
It's not a loop.
Yeah,
do you have an answer?
I have an answer. The rooster had an egg, but the egg had a mutation and turned into a chicken.
Okay, but then how did the rooster get there?
Same thing. It doesn't matter. It's not asking.
It's just mutations all the way down.
It's not asking whether the.
But it makes me think. Is it mutations since the beginning of time?
Yes. That's how we. How do you think we were created?
But then.
We came from a fish.
How did the fish get there? How did the fish get there?
God. I don't know.
God. All right. Thank you, Dylan Tovitz.
No. That's actually not true. The fish came from algae or bacteria in the sea.
How'd the algae get there?
Sand.
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 Sand turned into a living thing.
How?
Sand became bacteria. It just like snapped into it. I don't know. Okay.
You heard it here first. We are sand people. Dylan Tovitz, thank you very much. All right. Well, you know what? I had a blast today.
So did we.
Thank you both for coming on the show.
Thank you, Sam.
When is the next edition of Lance come out?
Soon, hopefully.
Soon. It's the December issue should be out.
Yeah. Next.
By the end of December. Yeah. No, well, before break.
Yeah.
All right, before break. Okay. Be on the lookout for the December issue of The Lance. Thank you very much for tuning in. Thank you to Sia and Dylan. Thank you, Miles Dax. Thank you, all of our crew members. Thank you, Mr. Daly. Thank you, Mr. G, of course. And, that's all we have. Let's go, Bills. And this is Sam Shambrow signing off. See you next week.